Textures are a great way to add realism of an appearance to your model within Visualize. There are various websites where you can find textures for free, such as Polyhaven, although there may be an occasion where you find the perfect texture, but it's not seamless, meaning that it is unable to be repeated without any breaks or seams. Each corner of the texture image must meet up and match perfectly with one another to be applied within a visualized model. Within this tutorial, I will demonstrate how to create a seamless texture using an image taken from the web and convert the texture into a bump map to create even more realism when applied and visualized. So let's jump straight into Photoshop. We currently have a texture taken from the web, and we will use this to make it seamless within a new Photoshop document. I'm going to use a canvas of 2000 by 2000. The size isn't too important, but I would recommend keeping it square. Obviously, the larger the document, the better the image quality will be. However, the larger the document, the bigger the file size, so it's best to get the balance between the two. We also want to ensure that we keep to the color mode RGB. Once done, I'm going to press create. I'm going to flick back to the texture. I'm going to unlock the layer and drag the texture onto the new file I just created. I'm going to place it in the best location, and I'm going to use Ctrl T, which is the transform tool, to move and scale it accordingly. We then want to crop the image to be the same size as the canvas. I'm going to select the crop tool, and I'm going to ensure that I'm in original ratio. I'm then going to press the tick to confirm. Once done, we then want to create our seamless texture. I'm going to do this by going to Filter, Other, and Offset. It splits the image into four quadrants and mirrors them inwards. I want the offset to lie exactly in the middle of the canvas, so we want the horizontal and vertical to be half of the canvas size. So in this case, it's going to be 1000 and 1000. Once done, I'm going to hit OK. The texture is now seamless, but you can probably see where we have breaks and seams where the four quadrant edges lie. So we'll need to clean this up. There are a variety of tools to do this. I'm going to show you two of my favourites. I firstly like to use the Spot Healing Brush to blend in edges nicely, followed by the Patch tool to fill in any blank areas. Ensure when you are doing this you are not changing any areas around the edges of the canvas, otherwise it will no longer be seamless. Once happy, you can then edit your image in any other way desired. Here, for example, I'm just going to lower the brightness slightly. Again, once you're happy, I'm then going to export my texture, going to File, Export, and Export As. I am then going to leave all the settings as default and press Export. I'm then going to save in the relevant location. Here I'm just saving in the default Visualize library location, and I'm going to name it accordingly and hit Save. I am then going to duplicate the image and create a normal map. As well as the color pattern, this will allow us to simulate the texture on a surface within Visualize. With this duplicated image, I'm then going to create my normal map, going to Filter, 3D, and Generate Normal Map. You are then able to see a preview of our normal map and how this will affect the 3D object. There are several settings available to you within here. Feel free to have a play around, and once happy, press OK. I am then going to export this in the same way as before and in the same file location. Again, going to File, Export, Export As, leaving the default settings the same, and then saving it within the Visualize library. Once done, we can then switch over to Visualize. We are going to be creating and adding our texture to the backboard behind the velvetizer. I'm going to switch to a free camera so I can move around within the viewport. We then want to switch back to the Appearances tab and select on the marble texture. I'm going to switch to the Textures tab and select Color. We then want to browse to where we saved our texture and select Open. You will then see the image be applied to the part within the viewport. We then want to do the same thing for the bump map. I'm going to select on Bump, but of course selecting the normal map image that we created instead this time. I'm then going to hit Open. We want to ensure that we have sync textures ticked. This ensures that any values changed from one type of texture map will be copied over to another. So for example, if we change the tiling on the color tab, it will pull through to the bump map tab as well. We can then adjust our texture accordingly, changing the depth of the bump map and the tiling. Notice that the pattern remains seamless when changing the tiling values. Once happy, we can switch back to accurate mode and the original camera to see the final result. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial on how to edit and create a seamless texture within Photoshop and then apply it within Visualize.